Hey savvy people, it's Savvy Nick here, and welcome to the Grub Rescue Screen. No one enjoys seeing the screen since it means something has been messed up with the bootloader, but today I figured I'll show you how to attempt to repair Grub from Grub Rescue. First, we can start out by hitting Tab a couple times just to see the various different commands that we can run with Grub Rescue. There's plenty of commands, and Grub Rescue itself is a fairly useful tool as long as you know how to navigate with it and set the proper partition to be booted. So this happened to me after a fresh install of a new Linux operating system. I was trying to install Ubuntu here, and it didn't go quite as well as I would have wanted it to, and got this Grub Rescue screen. The first thing I want to do is type in ls and press enter. And if you're new and stopping by to watch this video today, make sure to subscribe below and hit the notification bell for more Linux and programming videos. And after doing ls, this will show us all the various different hard drives available on the system. So these don't necessarily have to be hard drives, they can be NVMe SSDs, regular SSDs, or actual hard disks. So don't let the name fool you, HD, just know it represents some type of a storage disk. So to make this simpler, I have three different hard disks, HD0, HD1, and HD2, which adds up to the physical amount that I have in my computer. And now I need to find which one is the correct disk in order to try saving my new install. Now, you might not have multiple disks, maybe you only have one, and it failed on just installing on one hard drive. That'll make it much easier on you. But here I can look through the various different partitions. The very first thing is I'm going to ignore the HD0, HD1, and HD2. That's because that's the entire disk. I'm looking for a specific partition, and that's the root file partition. Normally, on Linux distributions, the first GPT partition is going to be the EFI partition, and then the second partition is going to be your root file system. You might have it set up a little differently than that, but that's okay. We can list things and figure out what's correct. So I'll first start out by doing list. I'll do ls for list, and then I'll list the HD0. I'll just start with the very first drive, and GPT1 with a comma in between, and then a forward slash, and this allows me to see if there's anything inside, and I typed that wrong, I meant GPT. So try that again, and now I see an EFI folder inside of HD0 GPT1. So I'm not interested in this. This is because I have a UEFI-based BIOS computer. Your disks might be named a little bit differently, but it's the same concept. I'll list the next partition in this same drive, so HD0, GPT2, and another forward slash. And now I can see there's a swap file, as well as a boot folder, a home folder, and a few other folders sitting here. So this does look like a root file partition, and I'm in the root folder. So if I hit the up arrow and I try to go to, let's say, the home directory, I can list the contents here. So now I see Savvy Nick. It's one of my users. That's correct. So I'm going to go one more level up and look. And I see that I have a few things in here as well. I just want to make sure that it's not one of my other Linux distributions. I'm not trying to rescue those. I'm trying to rescue the one I just got done installing. So I'm going to see if there's anything in my documents, because I know I left some stuff in there, and clearly there is nothing in there, which is a pretty good hint that I have the correct hard disk and root file partition. So if I go back and instead of HD0, I try HD1 and I do a similar thing. So for this one, if I check out LSHD1 with GPT2, that's actually an EFI partition. That's not what I want, so I can check GPT1. It's an unknown file system, so that's incorrect. I'm going to keep looking here, so ls. I'm pretty positive that's my Windows side of things. That's why things aren't getting detected there. So I know that HD1 is my Windows dual boot with the rest of my Linux distributions, so I won't be touching that. Now, the last thing I will be checking is the HD2 here. Of course, you might not have to go this far in depth, but I want to make sure I'm selecting the proper root file partition. So this time I'll list ls HD2, GPT2 with the forward slash. Okay, this one again has various different files and folders. So I'm going to traverse in home and then check if I have Savvy Nick. I sure do. And now looking at this one, I see a bunch of files that aren't standard with a brand new install. So I know that I've been using this Linux distribution. Therefore, it's not the one I just got done installing. And I finally narrowed it down to the HD0GPT partition. Now I can make note of that as my root file partition that I'm trying to rescue. Now we can set up where we want to boot from. So I'll type in set space prefix equal to parenthesis HD0 comma GPT2. And then there should be a boot folder and a grub folder. I'll press enter once I have that. Then I want to set the root equal to, again, parenthesis HD0 GPT2. This is my root file partition. And if you went ahead and made it this far, please smash that like button for me. It really does help me out. All right, with that set to go, we need just a couple more things. INS mod normal, press enter, and then finally normal. And after pressing enter, this should boot us into our Linux system. So let's give this a shot. I got Ubuntu here, and now I have a list of all sorts of different setups. This is because Grub actually found a bunch more Linux distributions on my system. You probably won't see this unless you have multiple yourself, and that's why my list of hard disks was so convoluted. But I am selecting Ubuntu here, and this should get me into my freshly installed Linux distribution that got messed up. And all right, after things loaded, it looks pretty good because I have my login screen now. I can log in with my password for my user. And now I'm in my freshly installed Ubuntu Linux distribution that wouldn't boot and took me to the Grub rescue screen. Well, that's how you rescue your distribution, but now let's make sure to fix it as well. So the first thing I want to do here is run through this real quick. All right, now I'll launch a terminal, and in that terminal, I will type sudo space update dash grub. It will ask you for your administrative password, put that in, generate a configuration file for Grub, and find any other Linux setups that you might have. As you can see on mine, I have multiple different Linux distributions, as well as Windows. Last, I want to type in sudo space grub install, and this time I need to specify in the devices folder the disk that I'm currently using, so mine should be something like NVMe, but I'm not exactly sure which one it is because I have so many. So what I'll do first is start up another program called gparted, and if you don't have it, you can install it pretty easily by running this command, sudo apt space install parted. It's a pretty nice tool. Type your password in, press enter, and this tool will help you distinguish your various different disks that you have on the system. So I select the proper disk to install Grub onto. All right, so if I do gparted now, that should launch a program after I put in my password. So the very first thing I see here is a convoluted mess of different partitions. Now this is mine currently, but that's because I have so many different operating systems installed. What I'm more interested in is this top right-hand corner where I can see my various different disks. So now I see I have a dev NVMe 0 and 1. That's one total storage disk. Then I have a 512 gig NVMe 1 and 1. And finally, an SDA, which is of a solid state drive instead of an NVMe solid state drive, that has around 120 gigs. So I know that the new Linux install I tried making was on SDA because it is around 120 gigs. And now I'm confident that I know what my disk device is. It's this last one, so /dev/SDA. After I've made that confirmation, I can go back and finish out the sudo grub install. I want SDA here. And this would have been filled in with whatever storage space you're trying to rescue. All right, if I press enter, it says that it's installing for an x86 64 EFI platform. Great, installation is finished and there are no errors reported. At this point, I'm ready to reboot my system and hopefully there won't be any errors and I will be able to boot right in instead of having to go through Grub Rescue. Let's give it a shot. All right, so this is a great sign. I see Ubuntu up at the top, and I see the rest of my Linux distributions, as well as even Windows here. what I want to select, I'm going to select Ubuntu, and let's see if things boot up properly. And all right, after things loaded, it looks pretty good because I have my login screen now. I can log in with my password for my user, and now I'm in my freshly installed Ubuntu Linux distribution that wouldn't boot and took me to the Grub rescue screen. Well, that's how you rescue your distribution, but now let's make sure to fix it as well. So the first thing I want to do here is run through this real quick. All right, now I'll launch a terminal, and in that terminal, I will type update sudo space update dash grub. It will ask you for your administrative password. Put that in and let the system generate a configuration file for grub and find any other Linux setups that you might have. As you can see on mine, I have multiple different Linux distributions as well as Windows. Last, I want to type in sudo space grub install, and this time I need to specify in the devices folder the disk that I'm currently using. So mine should be something like NVMe, but I'm not exactly sure which one it is because I have so many. So what I'll do first is start up another program called gparted. And if you don't have it, you can install it pretty easily by running this command, sudo apt space install gparted. It's a pretty nice tool. Type your password in, press enter, and this tool will help you distinguish your various different disks that you have on the system. So I select the proper disk to install grub onto. All right, so if I do gparted now, that should launch a program after I put in my password. All right, great. So the very first thing I see here is a convoluted mess of different partitions. Now this is mine currently, but that's because I have so many different operating systems installed. What I'm more interested in is this top right-hand corner where I can see my various different disks. So now I see I have a dev NVMe 0 and 1. That's one total storage disk. That's of a terabyte. Then I have a 512 gig NVMe 1 and 1. And finally, an SDA, which is of a solid state drive instead of an NVMe solid state drive, that has around 120 gigs. So I know that the new Linux install I tried making was on SDA because it is around 120 gigs. And now I'm confident that I know what my disk device is. It's this last one, so /dev/SDA. After I've made that confirmation, I can go back and finish out the sudo grub install. I want SDA here. And this would have been filled in with whatever storage space you're trying to rescue. All right, if I press enter, it says that it's installing for an x86-64 EFI platform. Great, installation is finished and there are no errors reported. At this point, I'm ready to reboot my system and hopefully there won't be any errors and I will be able to boot right in instead of having to go through Grub Rescue. Let's give it a shot. All right, so this is a great sign. I see Ubuntu up at the top, and I see the rest of my Linux distributions, as well as even Windows here. What I want to select, I'm going to select Ubuntu, and let's see if things boot up properly. And here I'm being welcomed again by my login screen. I'll log in, and congratulations, if you made it this far, you've successfully rescued your system using the Grub Rescue utility. How awesome was that? Now you can start using your system as intended and not have to worry about going through the Grub Rescue anymore. Hopefully you didn't have as many drives as I did, which will make the process much easier for you. But overall, it's not too bad of a process to go through. It's better than having to reinstall everything, and it's at least something you can try and use in order to add the Grub Rescue as a utility in your toolbox. Well, if you have any questions, comments, or suggestions, please make sure to post them in the comments section below. Also, make sure to subscribe for future videos and make sure to like the video. Catch me in a great community on Discord, and I'll catch you in another video. Thanks for watching.